Good evening, everyone. I have been entrusted with the task to introduce a personality who as such needs no introduction. But I'll just take it forward very briefly. Devendraji, at the age of 22, became the corporator in the Nagpur Municipal Corporation in 1992. Devendraji was the youngest mayor of Nagpur in 1997. Since then, in 1999 onwards, Devendraji is representing Nagpur Southwest constituency in the Vidhan Sabha. In 2014, Devendraji became the Chief Minister of Maharashtra. In 2019, Devendraji has been serving as the Leader of Opposition in the state of Maharashtra. Now I want to request Devendraji to kindly address the gathering and enlighten all of us with his wisdom.
जस्टिस सुरेश गुप्ते जी, आशीष कुमार चौहान जी, एडवोकेट अनिल सिंह जी, ऑथर्स राजू गुप्ते जी, आनंद विमय जी, ऑल द डिग्निटरीज ऑफ द डायस, फ्रेंड्स, इट गिव्स मी इमेंस ऑनर to be part of this application ceremony of Brand Wars. Justice Bhutte was telling and was very forthcoming in saying that he does not like to speak on the issues where he doesn't have in-depth knowledge. But I am from a fraternity where we are bound to speak on anything and everything, whether we know about it or we do not know it. So here am I. I'll be very brief because I think Ashish's address was wonderful and it was like a keynote address. So nothing much remains. But I am told that the critics say that this book is written in a very simple language. As simple as a professor who once went to a class and addressed the students and said, "Guys, I would like to teach you about marketing and advertising in just 4 sentences. Students were amazed. And he said, "Look, if you go to a party and you like a girl and you go to her and tell her, 'Look, I have a decent job, I have a good car, I have a good apartment, would you marry me? This is a direct market.'" If you don't have guts and you say your friend, and your friend goes and says, "Look, that boy sitting there is very good friend of mine, he has got a decent car, blah blah blah, would you marry him?" Says, "This is advertising." And then he said, "If both of you could not gather the courage of talking to the girl and you just took her phone number, went home and called her and said, 'Look, we met at the party, I like you and have a decent apartment and blah blah blah, will you marry me?' It's telemarketing." And then he said, "Finally, if you go to the girl and you tell her, 'I'm like this and that and all blah blah blah,' and she slaps you, That's customer feedback. I think nothing can be more simpler. And I am told that in such simple language, the brand was is being written. I could not read it entirely, but I had a glimpse, and it's a very interesting book. And I think, as rightly told, that the strategic thinking has been brought into brand building, and it's something very unique. But for me, I think it's time tested, because somewhere in mid 90s or maybe late 90s, I was nominated on a diploma, Methods and Techniques of Project Management by German government. GIZ is their ministry, and there was a short diploma in Berlin. And when we went there, this project management was conceived through strategic management, and we were told, they used to call it SWOT technique, and we were told that how it was developed. So they said after Germany was defeated in the Second World War, all the thinkers in Germany, they sat together and they said that we were so prepared and we were sure of conquering the world. What made us lose the war? What did USA and the allied countries do to defeat us in war? And then after a long study, they came out with strategic thinking and they started applying it in project management. And I was fortunate enough to take that training, and even today, that training helps me because it looks at every angle of a project. From the psychological angle to the technological angle. And I think if you apply those techniques to project management, these strategic techniques will never allow the project to fail. And as rightly told in this book, ultimately, what is a brand? Brand is manifestation of collective trust. And when a brand is created, a photocopier becomes Xerox, a toothpaste becomes Colgate, any chocolate bar becomes Cadbury. That is the strength of brand. It becomes generic. And I think in today's world, brand is most important. And that is something which will give advantage to India. Because in last few years, with the behavior of China, where there is no protection of intellectual rights, where reverse engineering is something which is order of the day, I think now the entire world feels that here is a country with absolute order, with democracy and demography, with best of the minds, with all the laws which have potential of protecting the intellectual rights. It's time of India. And I think with the initiatives like Brand Wars, where all the angles, all the aspects creating a business model or creating a brand is dealt with, it will be helpful for all our entrepreneurs, especially the stories of startups which have been told in this book will inspire many startups in our country. I think the startup ecosystem which we are creating in our country is something which will change the entire economic outlook of our country, and the disruption which it's going to create will allow us to leap. As I didn't know that in the startup space we have got more investment than China. I think that's very heartening to know, and I'm sure with our bright minds we are going to capture the world. I totally agree with Ashish ji. Not that Prime Minister Modi is my leader, but ultimately you have to even sell a country. And today, when you have a leader, who is most popular leader amongst all leaders of globe, that gives entirely different outlook to our country. When an investor looks at the opportunities of investment, this brand Modi has created immense opportunities in the minds of people, because they know that if we go and invest into this country means business. I think technology is changing everything. Even now, the entire space of marketing is being taken over by artificial intelligence. We have seen it's not just marketing, but now in the political arena, the brand building and marketing has become order of the day. And look what happens. When President Trump became president, he used all the technologies to look into the behavioral patterns of American citizens. What they consume, how they consume, what they think. And based on that, he created his strategies. And at the time of President Biden, just by changing the rules of game, President Biden defeated President Trump, because all of us know that by just allowing mail-in votes, President Biden could win. If there would have been normal voting, no mail-in vote, then President Trump would have been the president. So technology has so much effect on our lives, including everything. And I think, as rightly said by Yuval Noah Harari, that in the days to come, everything will be decided by the algorithms. So we have to be smart. We have to be technologically ahead. We have to understand the market. And for that, the most informative and most informative book is none other than Brand Wars. So many examples. so many examples, real life examples of success as well as failure are quoted in this book. I'm sure whether we are in the space of business, politics or any space, I think this book will help us developing strategic thinking, and it will help us in every sphere of life. So I would like to congratulate both the authors and thank them for inviting me for such wonderful ceremony. Thank you, Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.